Hello viewers, welcome to our Facebook live session. Today we will be discussing on radiation therapy during COVID-19, and we have with us our specialist Dr. Sandeep De, consultant radiation oncologist at Apollo Hospitals Navi Mumbai. Doctor, we'll start with our first question. Can you briefly describe what it means to be immunocompromised?
Okay, by the term immunocompromised, what we mean is that certain individuals, they have an impaired or a weaker immune system or less robust immune system compared to other healthy individuals. Now, as we all know that immune system helps us in fighting off any kind of infection. So a person in general, if he or she has a immunocompromised system, they're more prone to infection, even viral infections like COVID. Now, there are various factors for having immunocompromised situation. As for example, comorbid conditions like diabetes, heart diseases, hypertension, chronic respiratory as well as kidney diseases, even cancer and old age. Now, cancer patients, both active as well as survivors, are supposed to be of lesser immune system function. And that can be attributed to the kind of cancer they're suffering from, kind of treatment they have received, kind of comorbidities they have, or even old age. A person is particularly more prone to having infections when they're having the active treatment of cancer. Now, if you look at the categories or a risk stratification in oncology, what we see is that a patient who has received chemotherapy in the last 3 months or is receiving chemotherapy. Number two, patients having extensive radiation therapy. Third, certain kind of blood or lymphatic system cancer which weakens the immune system. A person who has got a bone marrow or a stem cell transplant, or people who are on immunosuppressive therapy.
So, sir, does a history of cancer raise your risk of health complications from COVID-19?
It appears that cancer patients, both active as well as survivors, can have increased health complications when they are infected by COVID-19. By that, what I mean is that there is some latest studies from China as well as latest studies from US as well as Italy, which said that or reported that patients with history of cancer when infected with COVID have a higher chance of complications, including admission in the ICU, requirement for mechanical ventilation, even death, compared to people who are not afflicted with cancer. But to add to that, it's a very small number of patients, so definitely cannot be generalized to the whole cancer population in the world.
Does having received radiation or chemotherapy in the past raise your risk of getting COVID-19 or having more serious course of illness?
As of now, there is no substantial evidence that tells that a person who has received some form of cancer treatment in the past can get more infected to COVID-19. Having said that, but if a person is infected with COVID, the health complications are definitely much higher compared to the general population. The factors may be the patient who are on active treatment come to the hospital and come in exposure to the healthcare facilities, thereby increasing their probability of having more infection. But definitely this cannot be validated at this point of time.
So, sir, if a person is about to start cancer therapy or treatment, should they consider postponing their treatment due to COVID-19?
This is a very important question and a very vital question and most difficult one. Now, when you look at initiating or starting a cancer treatment, when a person is diagnosed, the next thing would be a treatment. So, certain things need to be looked at. Number one, what are the dangers of postponing your therapy? What are the chances of you acquiring COVID-19? So the best guide would be your oncologist. Certain things need to be taken into account. As for example, we call something called as a radical or curative treatment, where the intent of treatment is to cure you. The other type of treatment is called palliative treatment. So you need to discuss with your oncologist, what is the kind of disease you are suffering for? What is the intent of the treatment? What will be the side effects? What will be the supportive care for those side effects? So all these things need to be taken into account very meticulously before we postpone your treatment or start your treatment. To give you some examples, a prostate cancer, which is a very slow growing tumor, we usually tell patients to delay for certain times. Post-operative means cancers, say for example in the head and neck area or in the breast area, which have already been operated upon, can wait for a certain time. But a curative cancer in the head and neck area or in any other part of the body, I don't see any reason to postpone the treatment even during the COVID-19 timing.
So we come to the last question. What are the modifications made in the radiation oncology department in this time of COVID-19?
Okay, so we have undergone a major change. The very important thing is that we don't want you to come to the hospital very frequently unless and until it is absolutely necessary. So the most important thing what we have done is we are doing telephonic conversation or video conference consultation. So Apollo 247 is the platform in which you can be at the comfort of your home and can consult with your desired consultants. So when a patient comes, I'm talking of patients who are coming for radiation daily. So the first level of screening happens at the main gate of the hospital, where temperatures are taken, and if questionnaires are asked of about any symptoms of COVID, if that's negative, the patients are given a green band and they are allowed to come to the radiation oncology department, which is in the basement. Otherwise, patients to our dedicated corridor are sent to the ER or to the flu clinic, where necessary actions are taken as per the national guidelines. Now, first thing is about educating our staff and educating the patients. So there have been lot of classes being taken for our staff members. Staff members are given protective gears, which is called PPE, personal protective equipments, for their own safety. The department as well as all the radiation oncology equipments are disinfected and cleaned as far as the hospital infection control team guidance. Now, when patients are educated, they are taught about social distancing. So in the department, the sitting arrangements have been altered completely. They are made quite far apart, more than 1 meter wide. Then they are educated about hand washing. They are educated about hygiene of other things. And they are also taught about certain aspects of COVID infection, the symptomatology of COVID. So these things are taken into account.
Thank you, doctor, for joining this session. Dear viewers, if you have any questions related to this topic, please drop your questions in the comment box. We'll address it to Dr. Sandeep Dey. Thank you.
Thank you.